All right, folks, we are back here at TCAW Collision Course. And as you can see, Joseph Hazelwood is safely and all thankfully looked his way into the ring. And there you hear the music of Sean Cassidy. Now, as I was mentioning before, these two have just been going back and forth. And Sean Cassidy has been, I guess you could say, patiently waiting to get his chance at vengeance against Joseph Hazelwood. He feels Joseph Hazelwood has been a thorn in his side for the last 4 weeks, and I guess in a way he has, costing him his shot at the World Heavyweight Championship, punching him in the face and running. I mean, it's, you can understand where Sean Cassidy's hatred comes from, but he gets his chance here tonight. 15-minute Iron Man matchup, submissions Iron Man matchup. The competitor that gets the most submissions in the 15-minute time limit is the winner of the matchup. And I know Sean Cassidy has a few submission maneuvers up his sleeve, but I don't know what he can really do in this matchup. I mean, he's Joseph Hazelwood is more of a throwback style competitor, a technical wrestler. Reminds you a lot of ways of Ric Flair. You know, he knows what his finisher is. And as you can see here on the outside, he's working on the knee, hyperextending that knee and ankle there on the outside. And now he's already got a submission hold on the outside of the ring. Obviously, if Cassidy were to tap out here, it wouldn't matter. And you just see him wrenching back on the ankle and the knee on Sean Cassidy. As I was mentioning before, Hazelwood knows what his finisher is, and he will work on that body part, on the legs of his opponent, just softening him up for that figure four leg lock. Where Sean Cassidy, in a lot of ways, is more of a mauler. He'll just kind of beat you to death. And then, the Texas Cloverleaf, which is his submission maneuver, he doesn't really soften up the opponent to slap it on, but, I guess we'll see how it goes in this matchup. Maybe all he has to do is beat Hazelwood to death and, get the submission on there. Hazelwood will pass out, and then the ref will just ring the bell. I mean, who knows? But as you can see, the time remaining in the matchup is over in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. About 13 minutes, a little under 30 seconds. And STO there by Sean Cassidy. Sean Cassidy in the green, Hazelwood in the red. And now we've got a submission hold here, a butterfly lock onto Joseph Hazelwood. Just wrenching away is Sean Cassidy, but it's way too early in the matchup. And Hazelwood using the back of his head to hit Cassidy. It looks like in the chin, Hazelwood leaves the ring. Not sure what the strategy here is. Hazelwood, this is just wasting time. Hazelwood's walking up the rampway. Oh, he comes back down. Not sure what happened there. But there's a European uppercut by Sean Cassidy. Sean Cassidy throws Joseph Hazelwood, and Hazelwood flips over the stairs. And Sean Cassidy, this is the mauling I was telling you about, has Hazelwood on the... Well, now he's on the mat. But down the floor there. Unless he's going for a... Oh, and a running power bomb there by Sean Cassidy on Joseph Hazelwood on the outside, working on the back, it looks like. And there's an elbow across the bridge of the nose. And now he's got Hazelwood over it. Oh, now he's got Hazelwood in camel clutch. Hazelwood's making his way towards the ropes. He's grabbing the rope. And Cassidy just releases the hold. Cassidy punching away at Joseph Hazelwood, a side headlock. What a nice belly to back suplex. Popping the hips there. Hazelwood is down, and here's another submission hold. Stretching out the chest, knee in the small of the back. Very painful maneuver, but Hazelwood's able to get out of it and flips him over. And Hazelwood with a nice running neck breaker there. 11 minutes and 30 seconds remaining here in this matchup. Still have yet to have a submission. Or have someone tap out. Hazelwood once again working on the knee. That's exactly what he's got to do here in this matchup. front face lock by Hazelwood. Reversed into a rear waist lock. Oh, and a nice chop lock to the back of the knee. And that's exactly what Hazelwood is going to do throughout the course of this matchup. Oh, and a nice arm drag there by Joseph Hazelwood. We're now at the 11-minute mark. And Hazelwood has Sean Cassidy up, maybe for that brain buster. Oh, and he hits that brain buster. And Sean Cassidy now working on the arms. And once again, just throwing that arm back, hyperextending that elbow. And now Hazelwood taunting. Oh, but Cassidy's quick to get up, and there's a kick to the gut. Hazelwood reverses into a side headlock. Right to the eyes once again, pulling out all the stops here. And he picks Sean Cassidy up and drops Cassidy's knee down onto his own. And there's a knife edge chop and a jab. There's another knife edge chop. Like an Irish whip into the corner. And Hazelwood picks Sean Cassidy up. Got 2:15 remaining, or 10:15, I'm sorry, in this matchup. Oh, it looks like he's going for some kind of superplex. He's got him up and over, and a nice superplex onto Sean Cassidy. Now he has Cassidy. Oh, a nice nice maneuver there by Joseph Hazelwood. And Hazelwood, I think, is going. Hazelwood's going for a figure four leg lock. He's going for the finisher. And he's got it locked on, and Cassidy is in the middle of the ring. But Cassidy has nowhere to go. We're about 9:50 and left in this matchup. And Hazelwood's got Cassidy in the middle of the ring, but Cassidy is not submitting. If I was Cassidy, I'd go ahead and just tap out and just limit the damage. I mean, this is putting more damage on that knee and ankle. Oh, and Sean Cassidy looks like he's trying to reverse it. If he turns it over, and he successfully turns it over, reverses the submission hold. And Hazelwood relinquishes the hold onto Sean Cassidy, and Cassidy's able to get out of it. Oh, and an elbow to the side of the head, to the ear hole. Oh, and a big spine buster there by Sean Cassidy onto Joseph Hazelwood. Now Sean Cassidy tells Joseph Hazelwood to get up. And there's that Cassidy cutter. Sean Cassidy is the Cassidy cutter. Is he going to be going for his submission? Yeah, he's going for the Texas Cloverleaf. And if he turns it over, and he does. And it he's got Hazelwood in the middle of the ring. Hazelwood's trying to crawl the ropes. But Sean Cassidy has got it locked in. Oh, and Joseph Hazelwood taps. Sean Cassidy gets the first fall. The two men have to separate. The referee deems that they have separated. Clock's ticking here. Now here we go. Ref rings the ring the bell, but continues to hold. Hazelwood, oh, there's an elbow. That was a smart move by Hazelwood. That's what I was telling Sean, or thinking Sean Cassidy should have done when he was in the figure four leg lock. Hazelwood, he tried to get out of this, but once he realized he wasn't going to be able to get out of it or have really anywhere to go, he went ahead and tapped out, limiting the damage onto the knees and the lower back. Well, Sean Cassidy was putting, oh, and there's a nice angle slam there by Sean Cassidy on the outside. And Cassidy grabs a steel chair. And I guess this is a no disqualification matchup. So he's grabbing the chair. The referee doesn't seem to do, oh. But Hazelwood was able to get the chair out of Cassidy's hands. There's a knee to the gut, or kick to the gut, I'm sorry. Puts Cassidy on the ring apron. There's an elbow across the bridge of the nose. Hazelwood taps, limits the damage to the back and the knee, and he lives to fight another day, but now he is down one fall to nothing with 7:40 remaining in this Iron Man matchup. Oh, and there's a nice maneuver there by Joseph Hazelwood, and Hazelwood grabs that steel chair. Oh, and he hits Cassidy in the back of the head. I guess this is no disqualification matchup. I wasn't aware that this was no disqualifications, but I guess it is, as he just used that steel chair in front of the referee. Oh, there's a kick to the back of the knee by Sean Cassidy. Cassidy has a steel chair. Oh, hits Hazelwood in the stomach. And what's he going for here? Oh, the DDT on top of the steel chair. If there was actual pinfalls in this matchup, now we would have a pinfall attempt. But no, instead he's going for that butterfly lock of that knee right in the small of the back, stretching the pectoral muscles of Joseph Hazelwood. And Hazelwood once again flips Sean Cassidy over his head. Oh, and there's a nice neck breaker there by Joseph Hazelwood on Sean Cassidy. Ladies and gentlemen, we're coming up here on a break within the next 30 seconds with 6 minutes and 45 seconds remaining. Oh my God! And Sean Cassidy's ankle has got to be broken. Joseph Hazelwood just used that steel chair. Oh, and he's going to use it again. And a DDT of his own. Sean Cassidy's ankle has got to be broken. Hazelwood just used that steel chair and just stomped on it. With Cassidy's ankle in the middle of it. But folks, we'll be back right after this.